Ashley, let's go to the hotline, and let's bring in the head coach of the... Let me make sure I get this right. Hold on.
Record right?
Gotta yeah,
get the,
I want to
get the record right.
I'm sure he's going to yell it at me. But the head coach of the 6-2 Cedar Park Vista Ridge Rangers. We're joined by Coach Rodney Vincent. Coach, how are you?
I'm good.
Has your heart slowed down?
I'll tell you what, it took a long time after the other night for it to slow down, that's for sure.
For those who missed it, Cedar Park Vista Ridge scores a remarkable 49-42 victory at Round Rock Cedar Ridge on a last play Hail Mary as Kyle Brown heaves for the end zone and Jacob Bowerman hauls it in a 40-yard score on the final play. I guess what I'm asking, Coach, is what was the play call? Did you guys, you know, what was the mentality going into that final play?
Well, what we were actually trying to do is get down into field goal range, and we only had two timeouts when we started that final drive, and wish I'd had one more. You always wish you had one more, but did not get close enough that we felt like we were in range, and so. You know, we had to go to our alley-oop play is pretty much what we call it. It's a version of a Hail Mary. And we have executed it before in a game earlier in the season. And, you know, we were thinking, let's take a shot. If not, we're going to overtime. And I was really proud of our guys for executing the play.
Well, and you bring up that this is not the first time you guys have done this. This is your second Hail Mary that you've scored on. You did it at the end of the half earlier this year. I mean, is this just... obviously there's a little bit of luck involved in this, but at the same time, this feels like you can't get lucky twice. This feels like this has to be something that you guys have paid a lot of attention to and made sure you guys have put the work in on.
Well, whether it's victory defense, you know, where you're trying to defend this type of play, or whether you're trying to execute this play on offense, it's something that we work on starting back in training camp. Not something we work on every day, but we devote the time to it usually once, twice a week maybe. But every Wednesday for sure, it's something that we're working on. And then we get a little bit of it on our play the game script on Thursday. Not a lot on that day, but... I was joking with one of my coaches the other day. He said, "Coach, can you believe how lucky we are on that?" And I said, "Hey, this is the third time in my career in that exact stadium that we have completed one of those at Dragon Stadium." And I said, "The third time, it's no longer luck." So I was giving him a hard time, too, about it. So,
have you considered just making your entire playbook out of Hail Marys?
We may open up the next game with it, right?
We're talking to Rodney Vincent, the head coach of the Vista Ridge Rangers here on Texas Football Today. Get involved in the conversation, #TF today. Coach, this is, you know, we talk about this win, but it's just the next remarkable step in what has been an unbelievable year for you guys, especially considering what happened last year. Last year, 1-9, certainly not up to you guys' standard there at Vista Ridge, but now... off to a 6-2 start. What is to you? What is the biggest difference between last year and the struggles you guys had, and this year where things just seem to be going right?
I truly believe with this group of kids, it started back in November after that season. You know, as a coaching staff, obviously a lot of soul searching, hitting the restart button, whatever you want to call it, Greg. But we spent a lot of time. Making sure that our kids were bought in, and you know, the other side of that is the kids bought in immediately, and they have worked extremely hard from November all the way up through our off-season program. They had a great summer in the weight room, great summer with 7-on-7. It's truly just amazing the way our kids have bought in, and you know, now moving towards the season, the way we go about things is truly the difference. It has nothing to do, people make a lot of different play calls on Friday night, but you know, the way your kids go about doing things throughout the week is a big deal, and I'm really proud of this group for the way they've gone about their work and everything that they're doing.
One of the guys who I know has taken a big step for you is the guy who threw the touchdown pass that won it for you guys, Kyle Brown, your junior quarterback. I know the son of your offensive coordinator, Todd Brown. This is the guy that I mean, let's be honest. He took his lumps last year. I mean, he learned on the job in a lot of ways last year. But he has been, it seems like, spectacular for you guys this year. How have you seen him grow over the course of really his career?
Well, you know, when Kyle came in his freshman year, you know, we saw immediately that he was pretty accurate. There was a lot of things from a developmental standpoint that he was continuing to work on. You know, the biggest thing from last year to this year, though, is just his football IQ and understanding our offense. And then, you know, the second thing that he has surprised a lot of us with is just his ability to extend plays. He has moved in and out of the pocket really well and delivered on some scramble routes. And then to me, the third thing is just, you know, he has, from training camp until now, guys, he has really done a lot better with all the stuff I like to, some of the intangible stuff, the leadership stuff, the next play mentality, the things, you know, body language. I mean, he's done really well with those, and I've been pleased with his progress on all those things.
On the defensive side, you know, last year, you know, obviously not a ton went right for you guys. The defense really struggled, give up 45 points a game. This year, you guys defensively have made a big step forward. What do you think has been the difference on the defensive side that has you guys rolling right now?
I think it starts up front with our box players. I've been really pleased with our defensive line and the way that they have set our front and, you know, made it to where our linebackers and our safeties can make plays. They've done a great job of we're just better at the line of scrimmage with those guys. So I always like to give those guys a lot of credit up front. Our linebacker play, you know, a lot of those guys got experience last year, and so that experience has helped. And then in the back end, you know, we returned three guys that got a lot of work last year in those games. And our DBs this year, they've been fantastic also. So I've, you know, from a defensive standpoint, I think just, you know, we're a little more experienced than we were a year ago, and really have done well up front. And our defensive staff just creating that environment of the energy level and taking away footballs, those types of things have been a big plus for us too defensively.
It's on to the next one, though, and no rest for the weary. You guys draw Pflugerville-Hendrickson 7 o'clock Friday night. Hendrickson, team that in a lot of ways is fighting for its season. It's got its back against the wall. Needs a big win for you. I'm not going to ask you to give away your game plan with what you're up against in the Hawks on Friday night. But when you take a look at what you guys are going to be facing this weekend in Week 9, what are you seeing on film?
Well, you know, the biggest thing is they're so athletic on both sides of the football. And if you look at their stretch that they just went on, I mean, they took Vandegrift to the wire. They took Stony Point down to the wire. I mean, they've got a good football team that has been close and some really, you know, would flip their entire district schedule a little bit. I think they're dangerous offensively because of the guys that they have operating in the backfield. And so we're going to have to be really good because, you know, they're about 50% run pass right now. So they stress you in a lot of areas from a defensive standpoint. From an offensive standpoint, they've probably got one of the best defensive lines we've seen all year. And those guys do a great job with pass rush. Been extremely hard for people just to run at will on them. I mean, they have a really good defensive line, and that's a big concern. We, you know, we have to make sure that we are sharp on all of our protections, and that our technique is great on all our protections. And so, that's my biggest concerns going in. So, you know, it's a team that's a really good football team, better than what their record shows, that's for sure.
And it's just the latest in what has become one of the deepest and most dangerous districts, I think, in all of Texas, and especially there in Central Texas, District 13-6A. It seems like there's never an off week. You know, that's easy for me to say sitting here. I'm interested in your perspective. When you take a look at District 13-6A, I can't imagine you feel like this has been a cakewalk for you guys.
Well, for us in our journey, you know, there was a a reporter asked me the other day about one of the big games we were heading into, because this last stretch for us is all the playoff contenders from last year, the guys that are ranked 1-4 in our district. He was asking me about a big game, and I told him our game against McNeil, the first one, was a big game for our program. I mean, we are, each and every one of them is a playoff game for us. You can't afford to not be at your best every single night that you play, because, you know, 1-9, they all are good quality teams that can beat you. So for us, every week on our journey is a playoff game. And it was really good for our program the other night to, you know, we were knocking on the door in that Stony Point game, and it was good for us to face one of those big time opponents and be able to pull out a win. So for us, you know, we're humble and we're hungry, and we understand exactly how hard each and every one of these are. We have a long ways to go. We've got two games left, and we feel like we got a long ways to go to get a playoff spot. We got four big quarters Friday night.
But the four big quarters that came before them have gone very, very well for the Vista Ridge Rangers and their head coach, Rodney Vincent. Coach, really appreciate your time. Congratulations again on not only Friday night, but what has been a spectacular season so far. And best of luck Friday night and the rest of the way.
Hey, thanks for covering us today. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. There he goes, Rodney Vincent, the head coach, the Vista Ridge Rangers down there in Cedar Park. You know, a couple of big wins for Cedar Park area teams here. Obviously, Cedar Park's a big one over Hutto, but that is, and that's such a huge win as far as the way that the rest of that district shakes out, mm-hmm. because they're now 4-2 in district play, mm-hmm. and one more win and they're good. Yeah. They need one more. Now, yeah. I'll tell you, this is the one they probably need to get.
Oh, Henderson. This week, yes.
Because then they have a bye week and they finish at Round Rock. Mm-hmm. Round Rock's playing very well right now. If you want to make things easiest on you and you don't want to go into that final week scoreboard watching and praying,
yeah.
you got to go get this one this week.
And this the step forward they took this year, because I mean Vista Ridge is one of those programs that did not benefit from the move to 6A.
No,
because they were them and Vandegrift ran that district in 5A, that North Austin Cedar Park Leander area, and Vandegrift kind of got their feet under them a little bit sooner when they jumped up to 6A, because mm-hmm. That's just a fast growing area. But it took Vista Ridge a little bit, but now we're finally starting to see that program. Their sustainability in 5A kind of translate now into 6A.
100%, and that's they're the second smallest school in that district. Mm-hmm. It's them and Leander are right. The two smallest schools in that district. And what they've been able to do, the turnaround that they've had, mm-hmm. and I think you're right. Last year, you know, 1-9, I think is more of a reflection of just like, you know, yes, obviously the team just wasn't as good as it was this year. Mm-hmm. I think that's pretty
But also,
pretty
you look
plain.
At the score, they were getting hammered last year.
Yes.
Like,
I mean,
this,
they were losing by 30 points a game.
They lost Cedar Ridge 62-7 last year.
Yeah.
They lost to Vandegrift 36-7. That was 31-12 this year. Like, it was just,
right. Yeah,
just
you look at, yeah, turnaround. you look at the differences, even in that, right? Yeah. Even in the losing margins, okay? Right. They lose to Vandegrift 31-12. Vandegrift's, hot take, Vandegrift's the best team in that district,
right?
That's a tough, tough game, and they were able to hang with them for long stretches. And then they play Stony Point, who's on the rise as well.
Shut up, Stony Point last year.
Yeah.
44-0 last year.
And they lose 44-29. Yeah. But again, it's not just that they're winning more games. It's also that they are much more competitive in every single game, and they are looking good. One more win, they get into the playoffs, and Coach Rodney Vincent has them humming, and just a remarkable victory. The second Hail Mary they've accomplished this year, but this one is a game winner. And by the way, I had people asking me, they were like, why'd they kick the extra point? Because they score on the final play, but they need it for tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Because it's point differential tiebreaker. Yeah. So they had to clear the field and kick the extra point. Let's finish the game. Anyway, we appreciate Rodney Vincent hopping on with us.